The Aviators has covered the two largest air shows in North America, AirVenture and Sun & Fun. In June 2010, we sent a crew into a small town in British Columbia to cover one of the smallest. The picturesque town of Quesnel, British Columbia, played host to its first ever air show, the Quesnel Skyfest. This one-day event attracted performers from all over Western Canada and the Northwestern United States. The Aviators TV crew had a chance to get out on the tarmac at Quesnel Regional Airport and talk to a number of the performers and pilots who flew in for the event.
This is the first time that Quesnel's had an air show. It's going to be very exciting for them. I'm sure they're hoping to make it into an annual event, so we're hoping this one goes off really well. It'd be really nice to see another small airport like this having an annual air show. We need that in Canada. I think it's very exciting. My name is Ron Andrew, and I fly Pitt's S2B. It's 260 horsepower, and it really does its thing. The aircraft is a tube in fabric with wood spars in the wing and wooden ribs. It's very light, weighs slightly over 1,100 pounds. It'll cruise at 170 miles an hour. Put the nose down a little bit, it'll be over 200 miles an hour right away, and it'll go straight up for a long time. It'll fly upside down as good as it flies right way up. It doesn't care which way it's going.
So my instructor and I would fly
the big
around.
Shows are a lot of fun, but there are a lot of pressure. There's lots going on. The small shows, you get intimate with the crowd. You're right there with the pilots and with the people. And the whole community gets behind a show like this. And it's so good to see. You go drive through Quesnel and you see Welcome Skyfest and Skyfest this weekend and lots happening in the media. And it's so good to see a town get together, a region get together to support this event.
The show's organizers were able to bring together an impressive number of performers for a first-time air show. This included a Russian yak and 2004 Canadian National Aerobatic Champion Jim Rimac.
I fly a 1952 Mark IV Harvard, this machine right behind me. It was an intermediate trainer during the war. It trained hundreds of thousands of Commonwealth pilots during World War II. And after this machine, they went on to fly fighters, Hurricanes and Mustangs and Spitfires and that sort of thing. So this is a post-war machine, a 1952 model, and it was stationed throughout various bases in Canada. And I got it about three years ago. I used to fly the Pitt Special, and I would like to fly Hurricanes and Spitfires and Mustangs someday, so this is a great lead-in for that. What I love about this machine is that I've got the privilege to fly a vintage machine, and this one in particular, it trained several thousand pilots during the wartime and post-war. It's quite an honor, and I'm an Air Force veteran too, so it's sort of part of the heritage, I guess.
Making their way up from Washington was the team from Bud Grainley Air Shows. A father and son team, Bud and his son Ross fly a Yak 55 and a Yak 18T respectively. The Yak 55 is a thoroughbred aerobatic aircraft capable of tumbling and other complex aerobatic maneuvers. The Yak 18T, on the other hand, is a four-seat aerobatic capable passenger aircraft. The Yak 18T's 360 horsepower radial engine can propel the aircraft to speeds of over 180 miles per hour. While they may be an unlikely pair of aircraft, the Grainleys put on an extremely entertaining air show. Also making an appearance was Team Rocket's Ken Fowler and Eric Hansen.
The airplanes we fly are called Harman rockets. They're actually custom built. They're a home built aircraft. I built my rocket, Eric built his rocket. I've been flying mine since 97, so it's got a fair few hours on it. It's a very fast, very powerful, lightweight, home built airplane.
My rocket, actually I built from a kit. It's an F1 rocket. Kitted out of Texas. I don't think they're kitting them anymore, but they might make them again here at some point. It's a terrific airplane. Came in three big boxes. I put it together over the course of about 13 months or so. People ask how I got it together in 13 months. I just tell them, well, I didn't watch TV for a year. And that's basically frees up a lot of time to work on an airplane. A fantastic airplane to fly. It does about 230 to 240 miles an hour on cruise. The airplane will climb about 3,500 to 4,000 feet a minute. It's got a good payload and good range.
According to Ken, the Quesnel Air Show grew quickly from a small fly-in, and the air show performers were more than happy to give the organizers a break when it came to price.
Anytime a new show comes along, performers tend to give breaks to the air shows, just to get them started. I mean, this is a small town. Small towns, it's a little tougher for them to raise the funds and get the sponsors to put the show together. So performers usually help out a little bit.
The event went off without a hitch. Organizers estimate about 2,500 people showed up to enjoy the show. Spectators were treated to a final formation flyby performed by Team Rocket and Jim Rimac. The Skyfest, combined with a stop by the 2010 Midnight Sun Challenge, is sure to make Quesnel a well-known aviation destination.